Very good morning, everyone. Today we'll be discussing about the characterization of the communication channels, how the communication is being dealt from one end to another end. Okay, so the communication, most important part is that it depends on the physical medium. Physical medium is nothing but how you are said to be transferring the information from one end to another end through the help of the copper cables, or it may be the radio waves, or it may be the optical fibers. How you are said to be dependent on that particular communication channels, that is said to be the importance we will be learning, and how it is said to be helpful. The bandwidth or the frequency or any of the parts which are said to be there, which will be helping you out in communicating. So mainly the communication channels, it declares a path. Mainly it considers a path which will help you out in passing the information. So between the information, when it is being passed from one end to another end, you have the equalizers. You can say, what do you mean by equalizer? Is nothing but it has to balance your signals. That is being done by the equalizer. Whereas an amplifier, it will be even used for the each channels, where the information has to be transferred in certain amount of specific channel variations that it will be dealt. Okay, and even the signal conditioners are nothing but the signal when it is being passed and when it is being not passed. When the signal is busy, the data it will not be passed. So that is nothing but your signal conditioners, where the only when the condition is being met, then only the transformation of information happens. And even the communication channel, it refers to the how the end-to-end communication happens, where the physical channel is helpful in communicating. That is the importance when the physical channel is being sending the information from one end to another end. The end-to-end information is being transferred. When it is being transferred, even the aspect of filtering is being considered. What do you mean by filtering? Is nothing but how much is necessary and how much is said to be not necessary. If errors are there, those errors has to be filtered and it has to be transferred through the channel. That happens in the communication channel. Remember, all these concepts are being important one when the data is being transferred from one end to another end. The equalizer equalizes the signal. Amplifier amplifies the signal. Is nothing but you have to, like, without any disturbance, without any problem, the information has to be transferred to the other end. So that happens in the communication channel. And when it is said to be having a good signal, is nothing but it depends on your performance, mainly the speed of the factor on which the channel transfers the information. Speed is nothing but at what level the transfer of information happens, and it depends on the bit rate, at what bit rate the data gets transferred. And reliability, even it depends on the reliability, how much data is being transferred without error. So it depends on your channel also, whether it is said to be able to send 100% of information or 10% or 20% or 50%. It is being able to transfer the information. So how much you are reliable on the channel, that is the importance one. And another one is that called as the cost. Cost is nothing but it depends on wired and wireless mediums, where the cost is important one. When it is an effective good cable you are using, it transfers the information faster. When you are using the optical fibers, they transfer your information very faster. Electronically, your information gets transferred in the format of ones and zeros only. So that also it takes care. When you are transferring, either it may be wired or wireless. Wired has less disturbance than that of the wireless. And electronic and optical, electronic it has a means where the data gets transferred in ones and zeros. And the optical energy is nothing but it depends on your light factor, how much faster your information gets transferred from one end to another. Another thing is your standard A and standard B. There are various standards in the cables also. When it is said to be using the standard format A, it is said to be having a higher version compared to that of that. And standard B is nothing but another standard which is of lower frequency. That is said to be the standard A and standard B. So in this session, you will be learning about the frequency domain characterization in the communication channels. Before that, we should be knowing what do you mean by a communication channel, what does it consist of. It depends on the various factors. One is the signal bandwidth. Signal bandwidth is nothing but in that particular range of frequency, how much signal is being provided, whether a higher signal or a lower signal. So whether the signal passes at a faster rate or lower rate, that depends on the signal bandwidth. Channel bandwidth is nothing but your cable, whichever you are using, or the wireless mediums you are using, how much bandwidth of data is being transferred over the medium. That it depends on your channel and how much limit it is said to be having. Okay, I can send maybe 100 KB or 200 KB or 300 KB, whatever. That limit is also dependent on that particular channel also. And the transmission medium, when you are said to be transmitting the information, it has some of the impairments. You have attenuation, the signal gets lower. And distortion is nothing but disturbances of the noise. And even the spurious noise, in between you have multiple noises, unknown noises. That is the spurious noises. And they will be having even the interferences. Interferences is nothing but the signal may have interference of the other signal being crossing over it. And each and every signal has its own limit of accuracy. It can depend on that particular accuracy. How much accurately the information is being transferred from one end to another end. Limits is happening because of this transmission impairment. Okay, that is communication channel. And today's session only till here. We'll be learning about what you mean by frequency domain channel characterization. The most important aspect in your channel transmission is your frequency domain. Frequency domain is nothing but how you want to transfer the information through the channel. At that time, the important factor is the frequency. At what frequency the information get transferred. When the frequency is lower, you cannot transfer the data. When it is higher, you can transfer the data. So it will be having a factor called as amplitude, which is the important one. When the amplitude is reaching to the higher level, then if data gets transferred easier. And even it depends on the pi factor, at what degree the information gets transferred. An external, like a noise, is there, then you have a 5f. When you are said to be transferring the information from one end to another end, an external, another factor which will be included in the signal is the 5F. Okay, is nothing but your disturbance. And other things which are there in the signal are the amplitude, the cost, 2πft is nothing but pi is nothing but one constant variable will be there. The frequency will be there and the time variable will be there. That is there in the signal. Whereas in the channel, when it is said to be having an output, at that moment an extra factor is being added, nothing but your noise or the attenuation. It depends on that pi. If it is zero, means you have a good signal. Okay, maximum it will not be zero, but minimum at least some variations it will be there. But actually the various amplitude, it depends on your amplitude out and amplitude in divided by amplitude in. The output at which the amplitude is being received and the input which is being given in the beginning, that it is being considered in the whole factor of the amplitude, that becomes the AF. Okay, so mainly your signal when it is being transferred, it depends on your sinusoidal signal which is being sent from one end to another end, at what level your amplitude reaches, that is also dependent. And the signal when it is being passed is when it is said to be high. When it is low, the signal is being not passed, it will be blocked then and there only. Means what? When multiple signals are crossing, you cannot have your signal to be transferred on that multiple line. Maybe after some time, you wait for some time, then your signal may be passed. That is nothing but your blocking and passing part in the signal. And even it depends on your bandwidth, how much data is being transferred at one bandwidth. Okay, 10 seconds, how much frequency of data is being transferred. That depends on your frequency, at what level your channel is being able to handle that frequency and send that frequency over that particular channel. So that is your frequency domain channel characterization. It depends on your higher and lower factors in the channel. Okay, thank you.